notification bell and never miss a video. Don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. Hello and welcome to another video with Megan Whispers. I hope you're having a great day. Now in today's video, we're going to be looking through a collection of Criterion films, and they are in Blu-ray form. So we're going to get right into it. I have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Criterion films, as well as 2 other recent movies that have come out on Blu-ray. And I have steelbooks for those films, so we're going to look at those toward the end. Now, one thing exciting that I do want to share with you guys is that I actually have set up an Amazon store. So because of my following, which, by the way, thank you so much for supporting my channel. Because of my following, I have been approved into the Amazon Influencer Program. So basically that just means that I can share links with you guys to products that are just featured on my little Amazon store. And you guys can help support my channel with no additional cost to you. And the way that works is you would go to the link that I would share, and then anything that you purchase during that time through the link, a percentage of that purchase would go to support me and my channel. So you would not be paying anything additional. The price would be just the same as if you had bought a product normally on Amazon, except in this case, I would receive a small commission, which would go to supporting my channel. So guys, this is a great way to support my channel. It's just a simple way to pick up the Amazon products that you might already be buying, but also support my channel. So guys, thank you so much. You can check out those links in the video description, and I will also just put a reminder in the comments. Now today's topic came from the weekly poll that we do on my channel every single Monday. So you guys can go ahead and vote on the weekly poll for next Monday, and we'll find out what video will come to us next Monday. In this case, the video about the Criterion Collection won out. Now it's funny because that topic had been in Sure to him. has a matte finish here. So it just kind of feels nice in the hand with this finish. And we're going to go ahead and just put this back in our case right there. Again, being very careful not to add any scratches. Now, another cool thing about Criterions is that they usually include a little booklet. And this booklet is no joke. They really include a lot of information, as you can see. And so we're going to go through this and just kind of take a look at what's included. This is what the front looks like. This, again, has somewhat of a... See, it's not quite a matte finish, but it's also not a glossy finish. I'm not sure which falls in between, what wording to use, but it feels very nice. And the paper is of a good weight and quality. So let's take a closer look inside and let's open this up. We're just going to flip the page, just gently kind of guide it down.
So we're getting lots of back.
next you're going to move on to 8.5 by Federico Fellini, and this is the cover right here. Now this film came out in 1963 as well, it looks like. Let's take another look. Yes. So that's kind of interesting. Both these films came out at the same time, or at least in the same year. Taking a look at the back, this is what the design looks like. Oh, and it looks like I had mispronounced the name initially. It is actually Federico, not Frederico. So that's F-E-D-E-R. Marcello Mastroianni plays Guido Anselmi, a director whose new project is collapsing around him, along with his life. One of the greatest films about film ever made, Federico Fellini's 8.5 turns one man's artistic crisis into a grand epic of the cinema. An early working title for 8.5 was The Beautiful Confusion, and Fellini's masterpiece is exactly that, a shimmering dream, a circus, and a magic act. And then we have some special features listed below right here. Now let's take a look inside this one. And I do just want to say that for the rest of these ones, since we already kind of reviewed the details going over the first film, we're going to kind of breeze through the rest of these. Let's take a moment just to look at this disc. This one has a very simple design, as you can see. We have the C for the Criterion logo, and then the 8.5 logo as well. And then the booklet looks like this. Let's flip through this booklet, and we'll kind of see if it has any gems to share with us.
Film called
to the American Southwest in Paris, Texas, a profoundly moving character study written by Pulitzer Prize-winning playwright Sam Shepard. Paris, Texas follows the mysterious, nearly mute drifter Travis, a magnificent Harry Dean Stanton, whose face is a landscape all its own, as he tries to reconnect with his young son living with his brother, played by Dean Stockwell, in Los Angeles, and his missing wife, played by Natasha Kinski. From this simple setup, Fenders and Shepard produce a powerful statement on codes of masculinity and the myth of the American family, as well as an exquisite visual exploration of a vast, crumbling world of canyons and neon. This one was from 1984. It's 145 minutes in color with surround sound, an aspect ratio of 1.78 to 1. Now, this film I have seen, and it has a great soundtrack to it as well, a great score, and I just remember it being very moving. Now, I haven't seen this in a few years, so unfortunately I can't give a level of great detail about it, but I do remember that it was a very moving film, and it just incites a lot of emotion in the viewer, and so I do like that, and I do recommend it. Of course, you guys can go ahead and search for trailers for any of these films and find out more about them in more of an audio-visual sense, beyond just the description, and see if you want to go ahead and get the films. Now, when we open this is what we see. In this case, the scene logo is very, very subtle. I'm not sure if it's kind of picking up on camera, but it should. And we have some kind of colors kind of drifting together here. And then right here is our booklet. So it looks a little bit frayed. To be honest, I don't like putting the booklets in this way because they're kind of more difficult to take out. And as you can see, you kind of have to peel up a page in order to remove them. So I actually would prefer that they be put in this way, so that when you go to take them out, you can just grab the whole binding and remove it like that. Let's take a look at this particular one right here. And so this is the main character. Harry Dean Stanton is the actor, I believe, like we just read. And that is definitely the back of the booklet, so I guess we'll flip over to the front. Now this is, I believe, the actress that plays the missing wife in the plot. So let's go ahead and just flip through. So here we have a little outline of a postcard. And I think you could actually use these for postcards if you wanted to. You can pretty much use anything for a postcard, actually. You could use a random piece of cardboard for a postcard if you wanted. And it would totally work as long as you had a stamp on it. So right here, this is the table of contents. As we flip, we see a map image alongside the casting listing. And then we continue to look on, and it says On the Road Again. Right there, there's a billboard. And this is an article that is shared right here, including some extra photos. series of vignettes. Yes, it is. Okay, let's read the back and find out a bit more. Unfolding in a series of 8 mythic vignettes, this late work by Akira Kurosawa was inspired by the beloved director's own nighttime visions, along with stories from Japanese folklore. In a visually sumptuous journey through the master's imagination, tales of childlike wonder give way to apocalyptic apparitions. A young boy stumbles on a fox wedding in a forest. A soldier confronts the ghosts of the war dead. A power plant meltdown smothers a seaside landscape in radioactive fumes, interspersed with reflections on the redemptive power of creation, including a richly textured tribute to Vincent van Gogh, who is played by Martin Scorsese. Akira Kurosawa's Dreams is both a showcase for its maker's artistry at its most unbridled and a deeply personal lament for a world at the mercy of human ignorance. Let's take a look at the inside of this. It's 120 minutes in color. And so this is the cover, by the way. So you can see right off the bat that this is a very colorful film. And here we have the Criterion C logo on the disc. And let's take a look at this booklet. Put aside the disc case. Okay. We'll take a quick look through this booklet.
White and black.
finished college and is already lost in a sea of confusion and barely contained angst when he becomes sexually involved with a friend of his parents, the indomitable Mrs. Robinson, or Anne Bancroft, before turning his attention to her college-age daughter, Catherine Ross, visually imaginative and impeccably acted, with a clever, endlessly quotable script by Buck Henry, based on a novel by Charles Webb. The Graduate had a kind of cultural impact that comes along only once in a generation. Now let's take a look inside this one. This one is our last Criterion film that we're going to be talking about, and then we're going to move on to two more recent films. So here we have the disc with its logo for Criterion right on the front, and an image of Dustin Hoffman's face, and then here we have our booklet. It says, "This is Benjamin. He's a little worried about his future." And then when you open this, it extends to this image right here. Now this booklet is a little bit more differently designed. Holds out to be quite long, and on the other sides we have more information about the transfer, and we have more images to see, as well as information about the cast and the credits. So I just kind of tucked that back together. Is Dunkirk by Christopher Nolan. He had directed it and going on. Now, when we take a look at this cover, we see our main character, but this film is kind of also done in parts, and time itself is almost a character in the film, because time kind of flip-flops around, and you see the stories of a few different characters kind of intertwine, and the different parts of their stories happen at different times, and you have flashbacks and flash-forwards, but it's very seamlessly done. I can't express how much I really like this movie, and I love the way it was done. I've seen this in theaters like a few times because I just really wanted to experience it a couple times. So here we have on the back an image of a ship going down, and we also see the boat, the Moonstone, which kind of carries a few of the other characters to Dunkirk Beach to save some of the soldiers there. Now, when we look at the side, that's what the side looks like. And when we look at the inside, we have a few different things going on. Oh, and by the way, I just realized that I left this out of the Blade Runner one. I will put it back in a moment. So here we have the DVD. We have the Blu-ray over here, and we have what I assume is special features. Yes, it is, and that one's a Blu-ray as well. Now, the score in this movie was done by the same artist that works with Nolan for the Batman films, as well as Interstellar and like a lot of his films. And I think also Inception, but I'm not 100% sure. And that is Hans Zimmer. And so I really, really love this movie. Again, dark and dense. I absolutely love how they break up the storylines and intertwine them. Some of their characters in this movie are played by Tom Hardy, as well as, I forget his name, Cillian Murphy, I believe, is his name. He's in it as well. And it just is incredible. I really, really like this one a lot. The soundtrack kind of goes for like the entire film, and they use this technique in the soundtrack that makes it sound like it's always building, 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 which makes you feel very, very tense as you're watching it. And it's always like building toward a crescendo, but it never actually breaks into a crescendo. And so you just feel this like intense feeling the entire movie. And I think there's only an actual moment of silence like once or twice in the whole movie, because most of the time you have background noises going on, you have the score going on in the background, and it just really, really draws you in to the moment, and it draws you in to the world of what's happening. So I love that. If I could add this to the Criterion Collection, I would. And I don't know if it'll get there, but we will see in time. I would highly recommend that you guys check out that movie if you have not seen it. I think Dunkirk is really, really awesome. So guys, I am all finished for today in terms of sharing the films that we talked about. I'm just going to bring these over to get one more look at them. So here we have our Criterions, and then here on top we have Blade Runner, which I highly enjoyed, as well as Dunkirk, which again I highly enjoyed. If you guys have not seen Dunkirk or Blade Runner, I highly recommend them. And again, you can check them out at my Amazon shop if you'd like to actually buy my channel in that way, so thanks in advance. And then the rest are Criterion's here. I'm also going to put that on the Amazon shop. Now, since we have quite a bit of films right here, I'm only going to place these on the Amazon shop for probably like a couple weeks at most. So please go ahead and check out that link soon, because I don't want to clutter up the Amazon shop too much with too many products for you guys to look through. I want it to be kind of simple and clear. But if you guys do want me to keep them in there for longer, just leave a comment below and I'd be happy to do that if that's what you guys want. So guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me here and talking about these films and kind of exploring and learning a little bit about them. I really hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe by hitting the button right below this video, as well as turning on the notification bell so that you can find out and be notified about new videos as soon as they come out. And you'll be able to view them just in time for bedtime every time they're new. You can also find me on Instagram as well, at Megan Whispers. And guys, I hope you found this relaxing and informative. I think there's so much that films have to offer us as a culture. I think they are more than just entertainment, if you're watching the right films. Really hope you enjoyed, and special thanks to Jesse for providing all these films and letting me borrow them. I hope you have a great day or night whenever you are listening to this, and guys, I will see you in the next video.